Now we are going to discuss about the equality of tensors. If two tensors have the same contravariant rank and the same covariant rank, we shall say that they are of the same type. Now let us consider two tensors A and the contravariant rank, the indices are I1, I2, IP. The rank is, contravariant rank is P. And J1, J2, JQ, covariant rank Q. So we consider a contravariant tensor A, and again we consider another tensor B, which is again having the same contravariant indices I1, I2, IP, so contravariant rank P, covariant rank Q, J1, J2, JQ. So we consider two tensors A and B. So they are equal if and only if they have the same contravariant and covariant rank. So this must be A is having contravariant rank P, covariant rank Q, B is also having the same contravariant rank P and covariant Q, and every component of one is equal to the corresponding component of the other. So here the indices are I1, I2 and IP. Here also they are I1, I2 and IP. In A, the indices are, the covariant indices are J1, J2 and JQ. Here B, the covariant indices are J1, J2. So this must be equal, and the contravariant indices must be equal, and the rank of the two tensors must be equal. If it is so, they are equal. The tensors are equal. So in the equation 1, we find A, I1, I2, IP, here this equation. Here B, I1, I2, IP. Here is I. So same contravariant, the rank is P as well as the indices are the same. In covariant indices, J1, J2, JQ, here J1, J2, JQ for B. So the rank is B and Q as well as the indices are the same. If it is so, then we can say they are equal. So now let us discuss the addition of tensors. The sum of two or more tensors of the same rank and type is also a tensor. So only same type and same rank can be added. So if you consider a tensor APQR, so here APQ for the another tensor, this is a contravariant and this is a PQ. So if it is so, it is the same type PQ, PQ. Here it is R, here it is R. So it is a same type. Here for vector, for a tensor A, contravariant rank 2. For a vector, for a tensor B, contravariant rank is 2. For both A and B tensors, covariant rank is 1. So the rank must be identical as well as it must be same type. So the same type and the same rank, that alone can be added. So APQR plus BPQR, equation 2, that can be added to give the value C, PQR. So the resultant after addition, that value is a tensor of same rank. So here PQ, PQ contravariant rank. Here the indices are PQ, the total contravariant rank is 2, covariant rank is 1, and here the indices are. So for the same type and the same rank, tensor can be added and gives the resultant tensor of that resultant tensor. After addition, is the same type and same rank of the previous tensors. Now let us prove this statement. So in order to prove this one, now let us consider two tensors here, A, P, Q, R. You take one tensor, B, P, Q, R. Let us consider two tensors. Now first let us write down the transformation relation. So you express A, P, Q, R in the So this is a tensor component in the unbound coordinate system. For a board coordinate system, A alpha beta gamma bar. So alpha beta is a contravariant position, gamma is a covariant. So it's a mixed tensor, contravariant rank 2 and covariant rank 1. So this is a expression, this is a board coordinate system. So the board coordinate system, A bar, may be expressed in terms of the unbound coordinate system by the transformation equation 3. So partial dx alpha bar by partial xp, partial dx beta bar by partial dx q, dx r by dx gamma bar, b, v, q, r. So this equation 3 is the transformation relation between the two tensors. So the equation 3 is the transformation relation between the two tensors, which is one in the unbar system, one is the bar system. Now let us consider another tensor, B, P, Q, R. So in the bar system, we express this is B alpha, beta, bar, here gamma. So this is the tensor component expressed in the bar system. B, P, Q, R is the tensor expressed in the unbar system. So these components are related by the transformation relation, partial dx alpha bar by partial dx beta, dx beta bar by partial dx q, partial dx r by partial dx gamma bar. So this equation 4. So equation 3 and 4 are the transformation relation between the two components of the two tensors A and B, which relates the components in the unbound to the bar coordinate system. Now let us add the two equations, equation 3 and 4. If you add, then the transformation relation is a common term. So you take the transformation relation as a common term, and if you take this a common, so now after addition you will get this term A PQR plus B PQR. So this is the expression on the right hand side, and the left hand side, this is A alpha beta gamma bar plus B alpha beta gamma bar. So after addition you will get this term in the left hand side. Here this is the right hand side. Now the transformation relation suggests. So the transformation relation is very important. The transformation relation, here there are alpha beta. Here there is an alpha and beta. So this is a transformation relation for a tensor of contravariant rank 2. So this must be a tensor C whose contravariant position you have to write alpha beta. So alpha beta. And here it is a gamma. Here is a gamma. Gamma will be in the subscript. So alpha beta gamma bar. So this is the transformation relation for a tensor of contravariant rank 2 and covariant rank 1. Therefore, the term within the bracket must be only of this form. So from the transformation relation, you get an idea that this term within the bracket, both the right hand side as well as the left hand side, this must be a tensor of contravariant rank 2 and covariant rank 1. So C alpha beta gamma bar here, and A P Q R plus B P Q R, this would be C. So this must be actually, what is this must be C P Q R. So now let us substitute this value here. So this expression and the equation 5 reduces to equation 6. So on the right hand side, this is a transformation relation with the, and C P Q R. The left hand side, this is C alpha beta bar gamma bar. So C P Q R is equal to the sum of the two tensors. So if you have two tensors A P Q R and B P Q R, if you add this one, then the resultant will be C P Q R, which is, so the addition will be equal to C P Q R. So it will be tensor whose contravariant rank is the same P Q and covariant rank is 1, which is here is a covariant position, you have to put R. So this way you can add two tensors which are having same type and same rank. Similarly, you can do a subtraction. The subtraction, you take two tensors and if you find the difference, yeah, so equation C, you look at the equation C, 7. So equation 7, you see the equation 7, A P Q R minus B P Q R. So this equation 7, you will get another tensor which is D. D is D P Q R. So addition subtraction, this is almost the transformation relation is the same. So here you have to find the difference between the two tensors. So subtraction is also possible. So you can add two tensors of the same rank and type, and at the same time you can subtract the two tensors of the same rank and type. And the next one is, let us discuss about the multiplication. The multiplication, there are two types of multiplication. One is called as the outer product of tensors, outer multiplication. You consider two tensors, A, I, J, K, this is one tensor, and B, P, Q is your another tensor. You choose two tensors, and after multiplication, you will get the resultant tensor is C, here I, J, P, the contravariant, this position, so that index must be placed here, I, J, P, and covariant position, this is K and Q, so K, Q. So this outer product must be of this form, like the contravariant rank, see here the one tensor is contravariant rank 2, another tensor is contravariant rank 1. After finding the multiplication, the resultant tensor will have the sum of the contravariant rank, which is 2 plus 1, which is 3, and covariant rank 1 plus 1, which is 2. So after multiplication, you will get the equation 8. So this is the called as the outer product of tensors. Then the resultant set of quantities given a tensor whose rank is the sum of ranks of the two original tensors. So here we choose two tensors. One is this is a tensor of contravariant rank 2 and covariant rank 1. Now let us write down the transformation relation. See, A alpha beta gamma bar is the transformed tensor, and this is a unbar, this is a bar system. Aijk is the tensor in the unbar system. So these two are related by this transformation. So here tensor, I mean the components of the tensor. So instead of mentioning components of the tensor, we are using tensor. Actually they are the components of the tensor. So the components of the tensor in the unbar system is related to the components of the tensor in the bar system with the transformation relation. Similarly, if you consider another tensor, one is a BPQ, and which is in the expression in the unbar system, B bar rho sigma is the components of the tensor and bar system. They are related by tensorial type of transformation. Now after multiplication, so this becomes A alpha beta bar gamma B rho sigma bar. Here you write down this transformation. Partial dx alpha bar by partial dx I, partial dx beta bar by partial dx j, partial dx rho by partial dx p, and again you write this one partial dx k by dx gamma bar and partial dx q by partial dx rho bar. So write down the this transformation relation first, and you write down the a I j k. So the tensor, the components of the tensor at the end, a I j k b p q. So you write down this transformation relation within the bracket. Now this transformation relation suggests here you see there is alpha bar and there is a beta bar and gamma. So there are three indices in the superscript. So the resultant tensor must be alpha, beta, rho bar. So the resultant tensor C will have the superscript alpha, beta and rho, and here you see gamma and rho. Gamma and rho are in the subscript. So the resultant tensor will be have gamma and alpha. Yes, this is must be sigma. This is sigma. So this the product of the two tensors A alpha beta gamma B rho sigma, the resultant will be C alpha beta rho in the superscript, gamma sigma is in the subscript. So this is a tensor. So the right side A I j k and B p q. So if you multiply, the resultant tensor will have the superscript IJP, because this is IJP, here IJP. So this must be KQ. So equation 13. So equation 13 is if you take two tensors and if you multiply the resultant tensor, we have the its contravariant rank is the sum of the contravariant rank of the two tensors. Under the covariant rank is the sum of the covariant rank of the tensor A and B. So if you write down equation 14, so from equation 11 you replace A I j k and B p q. So if you replace this one by C, you will get this expression, and you can replace this one by this. Because the transformation relation suggests that this must be a tensor of contravariant rank 3 and covariant rank 2. So this type of multiplication is called as the outer product of tensor. So if you consider C I J P K Q, this is a contravariant tensor of rank 3 and covariant rank 2, and the total rank is. So if you take any two tensors and if you can multiply, and after multiplication the product is also a tensor whose contravariant rank is the sum of the contravariant rank of the previous tensors, and the covariant rank is the sum of the covariant rank of the previous two tensors that we have considered. Now next we will discuss what is meant by contraction of a tensor. In contraction, one covariant and one contravariant index of a tensor are set equal. So we have to make this is equal. The rank of the resultant tensor is decreased by 2. So since the rank is reduced, we call this is a contraction. So for example, if you consider a tensor here, A, I, J, K, L, and here the subscript for M, N, P. Now here, what is the total rank? Total rank is the sum of the all the indices. 1, 2, 3, 4, 4 plus 3 is 7. The total rank is 3. Contravariant rank 4, covariant rank 3, total rank is 3. Now let us put L is equal to P. So one index in the contravariant position and one index in the covariant position are made equal. So if it is made equal, then this becomes A, I, J, K, L, here M, N, L. So whenever two indices are made equal and there are two identical indices appears in the expression, that means there is a summation over that indices. That is according to the summation convention. If there are two indices, one is in the contravariant position, one is in the covariant position, there is a summation over that index. So it becomes a dummy index. So after making a summation, the resultant tensor becomes B, I, J, K. So the summation will disappear to B, I, J, K, M. So once if you make one indices in the contravariant position, one index in the covariant position, they are made equal, that index will disappear because of the summation. So after the dummy index, it will disappear. Finally, the product will have the indices I, J, K, like this is the M. This is actually M. M or this is. So this is a tensor of rank 5. So previously rank 4 plus 3, 7. Now the rank is 3 plus 2, 2, 5. So the rank is reduced by 2. So for again, if you make let us make a K is equal to N. K is equal to N. If you make K is equal to N, so they are identical. One contravariant index and the one covariant index are made equal. If it is so, then this becomes a dummy index. There is summation over K. So finally, the resultant tensor will have C, I, J, M. So we will get this one. So the index will disappear. So it will be contracted. So the contraction means the rank of the tensor is reduced. So by 2. So here 5. Here the rank is 5 minus 2, 3. Further, if you set J is equal to M, then the tensor is C, I, J, J, J. So it will disappear. Finally, you have the tensor is having rank 1. So the tensor is rank 1. So the once if we make one contravariant position and one covariant position, the indices are made equal, then the resultant tensor will have a rank which is decreased by 2. So by making this process, the tensor of the rank can be reduced. Now let us consider the transformation. So you consider a tensor A of rank contravariant rank 3 and covariant rank 2, and let us write down the transformation relation. That is the component of this tensor in the the components of the tensor in the unbarred system, and this is the transformation relation. So equation 15 tells you the transformation relation between these two components. Now that equation 15, you put gamma is equal to sigma. So if you put one index, so here one index in the upper position, one index in the lower position, this is made equal. If it is made equal, then you put gamma is equal to sigma in the transformation relation. Here this is a gamma and here this becomes gamma. Now let us group these two terms, because this is, you can place this the partial derivative terms at n position. So you can shift this one to here and you combine these two. So you combine this, and if you combine, these two terms, this and this, and if you combine partial dx gamma bar by partial dx k, partial dx n by partial dx gamma bar, and this is equal to the coronal delta, because this is a dummy index, there is a summation of gamma finally with the coronal delta and delta n k, so the gamma will disappear, so we get the equation 17. So we substitute the this coronal delta here in that in the above expression, you substitute this coronal delta, and this term is a non-vanishing value only when n is equal to k. Therefore, this equation becomes I j k, then n becomes k, because n must be k. This n and k must be equal. Then only it is non-vanishing. So this becomes a I j k m k. So this becomes equation 18. And now let us look down the transformation relation. The transformation relation is very important. Now the transformation relation tells you that this is a tensor of rank 2, tensor of contravariant rank 2 and covariant rank 1. So partial dx alpha bar by partial dx I, partial dx beta bar by partial dx A, partial dx M bar by partial dx rho bar. So from this transformation relation, this is the transformation relation for a tensor of contravariant rank 2 and covariant rank 1. Therefore, this expression reduces to Bijm. Here also it will be reduced to B alpha beta gamma bar. So the transformation relation tells you that this must be a transformation relation for a tensor of contravariant rank 2 and covariant rank 1. So one indices in the upper position and one index in the lower position are made equal, then it reduces to a and the rank of the tensor is reduced by 2. So by this contraction we see that the rank is reduced by 2. Now let us discuss inner multiplication or inner products. Now inner product is just an outer product followed by contraction. You do the outer product and make a contraction and you will get the inner product. Now let us consider an example. You consider two tensors Aijk and another tensor BPQR. What is the outer product? You write down Aijk BPQR. So this is your outer product. Now the inner product is you make one index in the contravariant position. So this is P, must be made equal to an index in the covariant position of the another vector, and that is important. So P Q. So if you choose this here, if you equate one index in the contravariant position and one index in the covariant position of the same vector, that is not inner product. That is a contraction. That means contraction. Now here the contraction is done by making by choosing one contravariant index of one vector and covariant position in the another vector. If you make these two indices are equal, then you will get the inner product. So this is Aijk BBKQR. So this is your outer product. And now let us choose. Now in this expression, this P is equal to K. P is equal to K. This becomes Aijk. This is BKQR. So this both are identical. Now, if you let J is equal to Q. So this is a contravariant position. This is a covariant position. If you do this, so then you will get another inner product. Aij. So this is J, and this is a Q. So here this is K K J J. Finally, what is the value? The dummy index will disappear. K will disappear, J will disappear. So the final tensor component is D I R. I is in the contravariant position, R is in the covariant position. So there are two processes. So suppose this can be also expressed as some c I j, okay, summation k will disappear and this will be q r. Now if you make j is equal to q, it will becomes this is reduced to d I r. So if one contravariant one index in the contravariant position and if you choose another tensor whose covariant position this made equal, yeah, then the rank is reduced. So this is this type of product we call as a inner product. So first do the outer product and make a contract. For doing a contraction, one index in the contravariant position of the one vector and another index in the covariant position in the second vector. So if you choose this or made equal k, p is equal k, then this product the rank will be reduced by 2. So this is called as a inner product of two tensors. That can be also easily verified. You choose a I j k, so this is the vector, and a alpha beta gamma bar, you write down the transformation relation. So this is your transformation relation for I j k, and you write down the transformation relation for b p q r, and this is a common of the tensor in the unbarred system, and this is the common of the tensor in the barred system. So you write down the transformation relation and write down this tensors at the end of the transformation relation for convenience. So now let put rho is equal to the gamma. If you put rho is equal to gamma in this transformation, partial dx k by dx rho, because you are making this partial dx rho by partial dx p, so you will get the same term, and here you change gamma to rho, so we look this term. So you group this term. So what is this term? This is, if you group this term, so this term will be partial dx k by partial dx rho bar, in partial d is rho bar by partial dx p is a Kronig delta, delta kp. So you have to substitute the delta kp instead of the term in this bracket. Now you put k is equal to p, otherwise the term will be zero. So for in order to get the non-vanishing term, you have to put k is equal to p. So if you put k is equal to p in that expression, this becomes a I j p b p q r. So this is the term, and here you will get this term. Now you are getting the transformation relation. Now this is the transformation. So this is your transformation relation. Now the transformation relation suggests that this must be a rank, contravariant rank 2 and covariant rank 2. So alpha beta contravariant rank 2, sigma beta covariant rank 2. So the resultant vector will have, so this C. So if you multiply A and B, you will get the resultant vector C, which is a contravariant rank 2, covariant rank 2. So this is called as the inner product. So you make an outer product and you contract by choosing one index in the contravariant portion of one vector and covariant portion of the other vector. If you make this equal, the product, the final product gives a tensor whose contravariant rank is and covariant rank, the total rank is reduced by 2. So this is from the transformation relation is very important. From the transformation relation you can get the idea about the and the total rank of the tensor, whether it's a contravariant or covariant or and the mixed tensor and so on. So the transformation, the type of the tensor can be determined only through the transformation of coordinates. Now you choose a simple example. So now here is a I am giving within the bracket, I am giving some quantity both sides. Here also I am giving some quantity. I am giving the transformation relation. Now The transformation relation tells you about the type of the tensor. So here you see alpha in Chandravarin position, beta Chandravarin, gamma, delta. There are four indices in the Chandravarin position. So this A bar vector is having alpha, beta, gamma, delta. And here in coordinate position you have two indices, rho and z. So it must be rho and z. So this side the vector must be Chandravarin rank 4 and Chandravarin rank 2. So the indices is as can be written from the transformation relation. So the other side, this must be A I J K L. I J K L. So this is A I J K L. So here coordinate position I J K L. So this is I J K L. And here P Q. So this is a P. So from this we can find the type of the tensor by just looking at the transformation relation. You can say about your the type of a tensor. So the transformation relation is very much important.